We take immense pleasure in introducing our chief guest, Mr. P.J. Joseph, Member Non-Life, Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India. Serves as Chairman cum Managing Director of Agriculture Insurance Company Limited and has worked in the general insurance industry for over 35 years. Mr. Joseph, sir, a graduate in business management, joined General Insurance Corporation of India in the year 1979. Later, sir, joined New India Assurance Company Limited and worked with the company for 29 years and held many executive and leadership positions in India and abroad, the last position being Managing Director of the New India Assurance Company Limited, Trinidad and Tobago. Prior to joining Agricultural Insurance Company of India Limited, sir was holding the position of General Manager in United India Insurance Company from 2009 to 2012, where sir was responsible for health and information portfolios. We are honored to welcome you, sir. We request sir to deliver the keynote address.
Good morning to all of you. Mr. Shobhan Sarkar, Director of NIA. Mrs. Alice Reddy, CPJC3. Mrs. Emma Fong from FAIR. At the outset, I'd like to congratulate NIA and FAIR for conducting this seminar on a very important topic and the topical subject of cyber risk. This is the third year in a row, the third year in a row I'm attending these programs conducted by NIA. And these seminars are not easy to organize, and to get a full house is even more difficult. So I'd like to tell the outset congratulate NIA for successfully conducting such programs. I've gone to the list of speakers, very eminent speakers with intimate knowledge of the subject. So I'm sure as a keynote speaker, I wouldn't expect me to get into the technicalities of this. And I'm told that a 16-year-old might be a more appropriate speaker than a 60-year-old when it comes to matters related to cyber and internet. So you have to bear with me. I'm just trying to understand from some of the colleagues as to what this is about. And during the conversation, someone mentioned that if you look at any entity, either you have suffered a data breach, or you do not know that you have suffered a data breach, which means that everyone who is in this business would have suffered data breach at some point in time, but many of us do not know what has happened. If you look at the statistics, because you read the newspapers, actually talked about in India, every 10 minutes, one cyber crime is being committed. Today, they say that almost 50% of the users of mobile devices have suffered some kind of fraud or not. So, it is a fact of life, like tax and death, that you will suffer some cyber loss at some point in time. And this is a new subject. Most people are not familiar with it. I have a mobile. What I do is to use it for making calls and probably sending some messages up and down. But many of us do not know the potential of this utility and also the risks attached with that. So it is in this context that seminars of this kind become very relevant, and you need to educate people as to what is the potential. So you need to, when you leverage these things, you benefit out of it. At the same time, you need to be sure that you leverage in such a manner that it doesn't put your business to kind of risk which can be catastrophic in nature. Unlike many other businesses or losses that take place, which the insured can bear or can transfer through insurance, this is the losses that can take place when you use the internet or such devices could be catastrophic, and I don't know if insurance can cover all the losses. So when you bring in insurance, it provides some relief. At the same time, bring in place risk management concept to be implemented in this. As Ms. Daniel was saying, there's a need for industry to adapt good risk management practices when they are leveraging the potential of internet and using electronic devices. Larger organizations probably have the in-house wherewithal to do this. There are several small and medium organizations and even individuals who do not know the risks associated with using internet. And it's there that the insurance industry probably can play a role in educating the customers about what they need to do to minimize losses and then transfer those losses which cannot be avoided. So we were having a chat with some of the organizations yesterday, and we were talking about the deductibles that are applied to some policies. And I was thinking that the mention was that the insurance companies keep reducing the deductible to make the product attractive to the customers. So I thought it was a disservice that is being done to the customer. Because we need to keep deductible at a level where the insurer knows that he's going to suffer a loss. He has to bear a part of the loss. So that he is keen to take loss minimization steps, keen to do things in a professional manner, in a manner in which it is expected to be done. So when you develop products, when you educate the insurance about the pitfalls of using this technology, there's a need for us to also ensure that he does his part of the job, so that at the end of the day, it is a product that is viable in the long run. But at the end of the day, there is no free lunch. In the long run, the product should pay for itself. The premium should, the actually priced premium for a period of time should pay for the claims, should pay for the management expenses of the insurer, and some profit of the insurer. So it is important that we keep in mind the pricing and the structuring of the product. Well, this is very relevant in the Indian context because we are we compete only on price. So, it is not a good thing for a product like this to be sold only on price. We need to understand the insurance requirements. Also, it should be a partnership where both benefit out of this product that is being sold. The other issue is the pace at which technology is changing. Now, the insurer will find it difficult, I think, to keep pace with the changes in technology. The product wordings and the kind of losses that can emanate out of the use of this technology, one can't imagine. I don't know what kind of risk modeling will help you to look at the catastrophic events that can arise out of use of technology. It is said that by 2020, there will be about 15 million data-generating objects in the internet. It's a huge number. We are talking about Internet of Things, we are talking about phones being connected, vehicles being connected. And today, one can produce electricity at home and supply to the grid. And if you imagine something going wrong at your home, creating the grid to collapse, the kind of consequential losses that can happen across the country, and again it can happen across geographies, because internet is a thing which it is open to use across the world, and in what we use here it can have an impact somewhere in a developed world. Like we have seen back office issues in India which has caused huge losses in the US. So these are the issues which one needs to understand and keep pace with. So how do you keep your insured educated? If you see the traditional products like a motor product, automobile product, or property and casualty product, these have evolved over time. If you see the warranties there, if you see the conditions and clauses there, probably have been put in place arising out of experience or arising out of a court judgment somewhere which has interpreted the clause in a particular way. And the insurers felt that probably that was not the intent of the contract, and therefore they went back and re-drafted. Here you have no clue as to what's going to happen. This is a new line of business. You wouldn't know the kind of consequences that you're going to come across. Or even if you come across such an eventuality which will cause a loss which is not intended to be covered, you keep on your foot to make changes. And then, devise the product that meets with the requirement. Any product that has, it has to react to the social changes, the economic changes, the technological changes. Because when you want to use, when I'm talking about social changes, social media is one of our most powerful mediums. You have seen a lot of issues happening because of misuse of that media, which can give rise to a potential claim. So, how do you deal with that? And then there are legal challenges. The courts are looking at it differently. They also do not understand this business so well. But you can see huge awards and penalties coming in case the entity which is supposed to manage the affairs in a professional manner is not doing it. So are you prepared and ready to react quickly to such changes? And then we are also living in a society where people are not insurance conscious. We have something called the compulsory third party insurance. You should have only half the vehicles on the road. You should not have third party insurance. And we know why it has been put in place. Because if you do not have it, apart from the social consequence, you also have a financial consequence. When you know it, and you don't buy it. So there is also a responsibility incumbent upon the insurance industry to buy government. To educate the public as to the need for this. While it is not compulsory, how do you make people aware? There's huge potential. They say that by 2025, the total premium will be around $20 billion in cyber risk insurance. And a good part of it can be in India, the way new startups are being established in the country, mostly based on technology. The kind of work we are doing for international organizations sitting in India. So there's a huge potential. So I'd like to conclude by saying that this is a huge unknown area, and it is important that these seminars are conducted and everybody benefits from it. And also the responsibility of the industry to create awareness and learn the potential of insuring public. So that these kind of events do not cause huge disruptions in the society and